I don't even really know where to start. Like, I've recorded this video now twice, and I can't figure out a way to start it, to say what I need to say, or end it. But the crux of it is I can't afford to live in Santa Cruz anymore. The rents here have gone up substantially. When I moved in here, it was like $11.50 a month. Now it's like $16.75 and going up to $17.50. I can't afford that. I make like $700 a month of income, which is not a lot. And it used to be more. Like, I had sponsorship, like cash sponsorships that kind of helped deal with things and helped with gear and helped with travel. Like, it made things work. But now I don't know how it's gonna work. And I've been mentally putting this off for a while. Like, I had Rampage that I went into. That was great. I had an amazing time. And I've been trying to edit that video together, but mentally I've been dealing with this. I've been dealing with the fact that I need to move out by the 31st, and that this is something I just literally found out coming back from Rampage. I don't have the money to keep living here, and the landlord's not going to work with me, and it's just not gonna work. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I don't know what I'm gonna do with my cats. I don't know how I'm gonna get through. It's not like I'm completely broke. I do have some money. I do have some income. I do have the ability possibly to have first and last month's rent on a place. But as far as being able to pay for that, it's very difficult. Like, I don't have the income to continue paying for a place locally. Like, even renting a room locally is like $1,000 now. And I don't have that kind of cash. And even if I did, that would be my entire income basically going to that, which I won't have any money to eat and won't have money to do anything. And then I was thinking, maybe I can move to Oregon. I have a lot of friends up there. Rent's a lot, ch lot cheaper. There's a pl so many places to fly. So much. Yeah, so many places to fly. Like, I've had so many spots shut down locally that's made hard for me to fly here without breaking any rules. So, like, that sounds appealing, but medically, all of my stuff is here. Like, my pain nerve specialist is here at Stanford. Like, I can't move away from that. Like, that's been my last hope. Like, this last set of nerve blocks, for the first time in a while, I felt human. And I felt like there was a bit of hope. And then I have to deal with this. And I'm just struggling. I wish things were easier. But they're not. Life can be a challenge, and I'm trying to figure out how to overcome this one. Santa Cruz has been my home for years, for longer than any other place I've ever lived. And I've lived here for now for like 15 years, most of my life, actually. And moving away from here sucks. I mean, the fact that rent's gone up so much has been crushing. And the fact that medically, physically, I haven't been able to be in a space where I can hold down a legitimate, 9 to 5 job. Like, I would have to have a job where I can work a couple days, take a break to let my nerves calm down, and then work a couple more days. Even though that would be hell, that's something I could do. But to meet those requirements with anybody is so difficult. To explain that to people is difficult. And most job recruiters that I've talked to, they're looking for able-bodied people to do stuff that I can't do, which is really depressing. Like, even a regular 9 to 5 job going to a cush office would be difficult, unless I lived near the office and could walk to the office. Or doing something from home, like I could possibly do a work from home thing. Because the issue for me is sitting is difficult. Like, it causes the nerves to compact, and that causes the nerve pain to exasperate. That causes other nerves in the area to contract, and it basically causes me to go to the ER because it spirals out of control. So, most of my time I've spent either standing up or laying down. If I'm sitting down, it means I'm in pain, and it also means I'm going to be in more pain. So, it's really difficult for me to hold down a normal job. And that's also making it really difficult for me being figuring out where I'm gonna live. Like, I don't have family to turn to. I mean, I have a couple friends where I could, like, couch surf for weeks, but then where's all my stuff gonna go? I could put it into a storage shed, but then I don't have access to anything. How am I gonna make content? I mean, I do have a little laptop I can make some videos from, but my main editing computer, that's been my life. Like, I spend so much time on my computer because I'm in bed, and that's just how I function. So, I'm really hoping, I guess, that somebody somewhere either one has a job where I can relocate and do it for a couple days a week or something, and that has really good health insurance because I will need more nerve blocks. Or two, a space where I can crash and heal and deal with the nerve blocks and potentially, I don't know, figure out a way to more permanently deal with the nerve pain so I can return to life. And that's a big ask, is asking someone for a space to live, essentially. And I mean, it'd basically be a under market rent price, because I wouldn't do it for free. It's a big ask. It's a really big ask. But I need to ask that because if I don't, then my channel's just gonna disappear. Like, if I don't make this video and say, guys, I need help, then I won't get help. That it will fall apart and things won't work out. But just maybe there's one person, two people, a few people out there that might have a solution or be able to offer help to get help get me through this time of my life and onto the next stage of my life. So, yeah, sorry to cry on camera. It's just very emotional. And it feels weird to make a video where I'm crying and asking for help. And it's not an upbeat video where I'm like, hey guys, this is awesome. Life is cool. Like, let's have a milkshake. I don't know. So, yeah, if anybody knows anybody or knows any possibility, I'm down to move. I'm down to try to make things work as much as I can. I mean, part of me is like, if I physically I wasn't so screwed up right now, I would van life it. I would be like, screw this. I have enough money to buy a van and to deck it out. I could just do what Mr. Steel does and go enjoy life a little bit on my own. But I don't feel like I could fit in a van. I don't feel like that's gonna work out with everything I'm dealing with. So that's out of the question. And so my possibilities of what I'm gonna be doing is so limited right now. And it hurts. Like, I don't know what to do. Anyways. Yeah, so like this video. Don't like it, comment. Send me a message. It's been a fun few years, guys. Thanks.
So long and thanks for all the fish. So sad that it should come to this. We try to warn you all, but oh dear. You may not share our intellect, which might explain your disrespect for all the natural wonders that grow around you. So long, and thanks for all the fish.
The world's about to be destroyed. fly back and let the planet dissolve around you. Despite those nets of tuna feats, we thought that most of you were sweet, especially tiny tots and your pregnant women. So long, so long, so long, so long, so long.
Change one thing, we would all have learned to sing.